Hi everyone, this is Nick, and I got a question from Jake over on YouTube who was using our zip code lookup template, and he wanted to know if there was a way that you could get rid of the word county from all of the data here in column E. This is the county lookup. So our zip code lookup template is a $10 download over on our Gumroad souvenir shop. I hope you check it out. I'll put the link down below in the description. But essentially, you can type in any zip code, and it will populate with city, county, and state automatically for you. So let's go ahead and type one in. 49423, that's my hometown of Holland, Michigan, Ottawa County, and Michigan. Perfect. So that still works really well. And this is really just built with an X lookup or a V lookup table sort of on the back end on its own tab right here from our zip code database tab down here. Now, if you wanted to get rid of the word county, there's a couple different ways I might do it. So once you are finished importing your zip code list, I might just go ahead and copy everything that I did. So just copy there. Create a new sheet, a new tab in your workbook. Just go ahead and push this little plus sign down here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and paste as values. I'm just gonna make that black. And so here are my values. Now, none of the formulas came over. You can see like up here in the formula bar, it just says Denver. It doesn't give you that X lookup formula that it would in the other, in the lookup tab. But now if you wanna get rid of county, all I would do here is select the range of cells that you wanted to remove county from, go up to the home tab, and then go to the find and select, and then click on replace. When you do that, the dialog box pops up. It says, what do you wanna find? And in this case, I wanna find the word county. And what I wanna replace with is nothing. So I'm just gonna leave it blank. And when I click replace all, that's going to take away all of the words county from this cell of data. Now, if you wanted to make it so that it was live in the workbook, you didn't have to do that copy and paste into a new cell. All you have to do is go over to the zip code database tab. We're gonna look for the column with counties, and in this case, it's column H. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to select all of the data. I don't wanna select the header because I want the word county to remain in that header. So I'm gonna select put my cursor here in row 2, and then what I'm gonna do is a keyboard shortcut, and it's gonna be Shift, Control, and then the down arrow key. That's gonna take you to the last piece of data in the column before a blank row. Now, there are a few blank rows, so you have to click this a few times. So I'm just gonna hold down Shift and Control, and then I'm gonna push down. You see it takes me to row 6, then I'm going to push down again, takes me there, down again, and I'm just going to hold down the down arrow key, and it's going to go all the way down to my final row. And this will just take 1 second. There it is right here. And there's our final row of data here. It's row 42,725. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to go up to the home tab, find and select, and then replace. And our county is already populated there, so I'm going to go ahead and replace all, and we'll see how many cases it replaces. We made 40,013 replacements. So now there's no county there. If I go back to my enter zip codes here tab, my lookup tab, now you can see the county name has been, or the county, the word county has been removed from the county column. Let's go ahead and type in Denver 80206. And you can see there's no county there after Denver County. So Jake, I hope this helps. I hope you can follow these steps in your own workbook. If all of you out there want to download this workbook, again, it's just a $10 download on our Gumroad page. I'll put the link down below. Or go ahead and watch our YouTube series, our playlist on how I made this workbook from scratch. And you can make your own. It's free of charge. So pretty cool. I hope you like this video. Give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit that subscribe button to get notifications every time I post a new video on data design, Excel, or PowerPoint. Thanks again for watching. I hope you're having a great day, and I will see you next time.